Hello, my name is Kinanah Yaseen. I'm one of the staff at the Vasculitis Center here at Cleveland Clinic. And today I'm going to present 78-year-old female with medical history of hypertension and recent diagnosis of advanced chronic kidney disease stage 4. Her baseline creatinine is 1.9, and the recent diagnosis of CKD was attributed to uncontrolled hypertension. She presented to our hospital with diffuse skin rash and shortness of breath. And on examination, she was hypertensive, tachycardic, and tachypneic. And this is a photo of her skin rash. And she was requiring high oxygen, and she had basilar crackles in both lungs. On evaluation, she had leukopenia, thrombocytopenia, and anemia. And she tested positive for several different autoantibodies, including ANA, SSA, SSB, crithidia, chromatin, antihistone, double-stranded DNA, in addition to having positive PNK and MPO and low complement C3 level. Because of her shortness of breath, she underwent a CT chest, which showed diffuse pulmonary infiltrates, and her bronchoscopy and lavage was consistent with diffuse alveolar hemorrhage. Later on, her skin biopsy was performed that showed interface dermatitis. An initial diagnosis was felt to be consistent with SLE, as 15% of SLE patients, they may have positive ANCA test, most commonly PNK more than CNK. Later on, she had a kidney biopsy, and her kidney biopsy showed post-immune crescentic glomerulonephritis, and on immunofluorescence, she had immune complex deposits, which not typically seen in primary ANCA-associated vasculitis. And the suspect in her case was hydralazine-associated ANCA vasculitis. And the clinical spectrum of hydralazine-associated ANCA is variable, but the kidney involvement is the most common manifestation in almost 100% of the cases. Post-immune glomerulonephritis is most commonly finding on the kidney biopsy, followed by immune complex. Pulmonary involvement is not uncommonly reported in the literature. Almost 50% of the patient may present with diffuse alveolar hemorrhage, lung nodules, or infiltrates. And we have so far 24 cases in the literature of pulmonary renal syndrome with very high mortality, more than 50% of cases. They may present with skin rash, necrotic lesion, and a skin biopsy may reveal interface dermatitis or leukocytoclastic vasculitis. In addition, they may have leukopenia and thrombocytopenia, which is not commonly seen in primary ANCA-associated vasculitis patients. They will test positive for several different antibodies, including PNK, MPO, ANA, antihistone, dsDNA, and low complements. But I have to say, there is no pathognomonic to diagnose hydralazine-associated vasculitis, and it's a combination between having overlap symptoms between SLE and ANCA-associated vasculitis, cytopenia, multiple serologies, in addition to post-immune glomerulonephritis with immune complex on a kidney biopsy. In terms of the outcomes, most of the patients had poorer renal outcomes, and this is regardless of treatment. Only 18% of the patients in our cohort here at Cleveland Clinic had full renal recovery. 46% ended up with chronic kidney disease, and 36% had end-stage renal disease. And the factors were associated with poor renal outcomes were the need for dialysis at the time of the presentation and higher serum creatinine, in addition to the degree of chronic interstitial fibrosis on the renal biopsy. Regardless of treatment, no disease relapse was noted in our cohort, and this is including patients who were not receiving any treatment. And this may indicate that patients with hydralazine-associated vasculitis may not require maintenance therapy similarly to the patients with primary ANCA-associated vasculitis. Thank you.